Empagliflozin is an SGLT2 inhibitor used to manage type 2 diabetes mellitus. In this video, let's find found. What is empagliflozin? What is empagliflozin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking empagliflozin? How does empagliflozin work? How to use empagliflozin? What is empagliflozin? Empagliflozin, sold under the brand name Jardiance, among others, is an antidiabetic medication used to improve glucose control in people with type 2 diabetes. It is not recommended for type 1 diabetes. It is taken by mouth. Empagliflozin was approved for medical use in the United States and in the European Union in 2014. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. In 2020, it was the 102nd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 6 million prescriptions. It has received approval as a generic medication from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA. What is empagliflozin used for? Empagliflozin is indicated as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adult patients with type 2 diabetes, either alone or in combination with metformin or linagliptin. It is also indicated to reduce the risk of cardiovascular death in adult patients with both type 2 diabetes mellitus and established cardiovascular disease, either alone or as a combination product with metformin. An extended-release combination product containing empagliflozin, metformin, and linagliptin was approved by the FDA in January 2020 for the improvement of glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus when used adjunctively with diet and exercise. Empagliflozin is also approved to reduce the risk of cardiovascular mortality and hospitalization due to heart failure in adult patients with heart failure, either alone or in combination with metformin. In Europe, empagliflozin is indicated in adults for the treatment of symptomatic chronic heart failure with reduced ejection fraction and chronic kidney disease. Contraindication. Empagliflozin is contraindicated in patients who history of a severe allergic reaction to empagliflozin, end-stage kidney disease, diabetic ketoacidosis. Side effects. Common. Empagliflozin increases the risk of genital fungal infections. The risk is highest in people with a prior history of genital fungal infections. Empagliflozin has been thought to be associated with increased risk of urinary tract infections UTI. Cumulative data from clinical trials have shown comparable risks for developing a UTI between placebo and empagliflozin. Empagliflozin reduces systolic and diastolic blood pressure and can increase the risk of low blood pressure, which can cause fainting and/or falls. The risk is higher in older people, people taking diuretics, and people with reduced kidney function. Slight increases in low-density lipoprotein, LDL, cholesterol, can be seen with empagliflozin, in the range of 2-4% from baseline. Pharmacodynamic. Empagliflozin lowers blood glucose levels by preventing glucose reabsorption in the kidneys, thereby increasing the amount of glucose excreted in the urine. It has a relatively long duration of action, requiring only once daily dosing. Patients should be monitored closely for signs and symptoms of ketoacidosis regardless of blood glucose level, as empagliflozin may precipitate diabetic ketoacidosis in the absence of hyperglycemia. As its mechanism of action is contingent on the renal excretion of glucose, empagliflozin may be held in cases of acute kidney injury and/or discontinued in patients who develop chronic renal disease. The overexcretion of glucose creates a sugar-rich urogenital environment, which increases the risk of urogenital infections in both male and female patients. Monitor closely for signs and symptoms of developing infection. Mechanism of action. The vast majority of glucose filtered through the glomerulus is reabsorbed within the proximal tubule, primarily via SGLT2, sodium glucose-linked cotransporter 2, which is responsible for 90% of the total glucose reabsorption within the kidneys. Na plus slash K plus ADPase on the basolateral membrane of proximal tubular cells utilize ADP to actively pump Na plus ions into the interstitium surrounding the tubule, establishing a Na plus gradient within the tubular cell. SGLT2 on the apical membrane of these cells then utilize this gradient to facilitate secondary active cotransport of both Na plus and glucose out of the filtrate, thereby reabsorbing glucose back into the blood, inhibiting this cotransport, then, allows for a marked increase in glucosuria and decrease in blood glucose levels. Empagliflozin is a potent inhibitor of renal SGLT2 transporters located in the proximal tubules of the kidneys and works to lower blood glucose levels via an increase in glucosuria. Empagliflozin also appears to exert cardiovascular benefits, specifically in the prevention of heart failure independent of its blood glucose lowering effects, though the exact mechanism of this benefit is not precisely understood. Several theories have been posited, including the potential inhibition of Na plus slash H plus exchanger, NHE1 in the myocardium and NHE3 in the proximal tubule, reduction of preload via diuretic slash natriuretic effects and reduction of blood pressure, prevention of cardiac fibrosis via suppression of profibrotic markers, and reduction of pro-inflammatory adipokines. Half-life. The apparent terminal elimination half-life was found to be 12.4 H based on population pharmacokinetic analysis. Dose. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Indicated as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes. Also indicated to reduce the risk of cardiovascular death in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus and cardiovascular disease. 10 mg POQD. May increase to 25 mg per day if needed and tolerated. Heart failure. Indicated to reduce the risk of cardiovascular death plus hospitalization in adults with heart failure, HF. 10 mg POQD. Safety advice. Empagliflozin is U.S. Food and Drug Administration Pregnancy Risk Category C and should be avoided in the late second and third trimesters, during fetal renal development. That's all the information about empagliflozin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.